He is declaring over him, time and time again, his might and his strength. And as soon as Gideon thinks he is finally making his point about how weak he is, I come from the weakest clan. You cannot use me. I am the weakest of the weak. And he says, I will be with you. Who are you calling me? You're a mighty man of valor because I am with you. The Lord said to him, but I will be with you, and you shall strike the Midianites as one man. And he said to him, if now I have found favor in your eyes, then show me a sign that it is you who speaks with me. The angel of the Lord comes to Gideon, calls him an epic name. Gideon accuses the Lord. The Lord is steadfast and patient. Gideon whines and complains and mopes. The Lord is steadfast and patient. Gideon now asks for a sign, as if the angel of the Lord and the continued conversation is not enough of a sign. Please do not depart from here until I come to you and bring out my present and set it before you. And then the angel says, I will stay until you return. Patient. Again. Gideon's like, I'm going to go. Don't leave, but I'm going to go. He leaves the angel of the Lord and says, you stay. So Gideon went into his house and prepared young goat and unleavened cakes from, what? I think it's a thing of flour. And the meat he put in a basket and the broth he put in a pot and brought them to him under the thing and presented them. And the angel of God said to him, take the meat and the unleavened cakes and put them on this rock and pour the broth over them. That sounds not delicious. And he did so. And the angel of the Lord reached out the tip of the staff that was in his hand and touched the meat and the unleavened cakes. And the fire sprang up from the rock and consumed the meat and the unleavened cakes, and the angel of the Lord vanished from his sight. Then Gideon perceived that he was an angel of the Lord. Eventually he got up. So Gideon goes and he brings something before the angel of the Lord, and the angel of the Lord demonstrates the power and accepts that gift. But for me, I think the big part in all of that is how it took something obviously supernatural to get Gideon's attention when all of it had been supernatural. Everything that the angel of the Lord was saying to him was supernatural things. He's obviously not a mighty man of valor. From the get-go, that was supernatural too. Just because the staff touched it and it sparked didn't all of a sudden make that the first supernatural.